Hey everybody, this is today's proverb. Today we're going to be looking at Proverbs 15, verses 18 through 20. It says, "A hot-tempered person stirs up conflict, but the one who is patient calms a quarrel. The way of the sluggard is blocked with thorns, but the path of the upright is a highway. A wise son brings joy to his father, but a foolish man despises his mother." I often used to get into frustrating conversations with my young children. One of them would scream and run off into the room, wailing like she had just had her limb chopped off or something. And I'd go into the room, I'd check up on this child, and granted, it didn't take long to stop running after them with incredible amounts of hustle, as I came to find out, you know, 4 children later, that the crying likely was over something like less than a glass of spilled milk. But trying to calm a hysterical child may be the most futile thing that I've ever attempted. I'd ask, "What's wrong, honey?" And through barely stifled tears, she'd manage to get out something like, "My awful sister isn't letting me play with her." You know, try telling that child that she's being a little crazy and see what the reaction is. Try telling her that she's making herself cry and she can stop at any moment. She'll make herself cry even harder. People always have the choice to respond one way or another, but we like to put the blame on someone or something else most of the time. My kids never used to believe that they could stop their wailing. It's still an issue sometimes, frankly. My kids always believed that the awfulness of their siblings forced them into this hysterical crying and these fits of anger. But Proverbs 15:18 says, it talks about this hot-tempered person and a patient person. There's a guy named Paul Koptek. He writes, "Hot-tempered and patient sound like qualities of temperament that one is born with and cannot change. But this saying urges self-control." See, self-control is actually a fruit of the Spirit. It's something that, as a follower of Jesus, we are given access to. I don't have to be a lazy sluggard like it says in verse 19. Rather, I can actually have self-control as gifted to me by God to work hard. I don't have to be a fool who is a source of hurt and frustration to his parents, like verse 20 says. Rather, I can actually have the self-control as gifted to me by God to live wisely and bring joy to my parents. My girls don't have to react to minor offenses with hysterical crying. They choose to do so because it appeals to the desires of their flesh. Paul tells us that we have a choice of walking by those evil desires or by the Holy Spirit. "Walk by the Spirit and you will not gratify the desires of the flesh. For the flesh desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the flesh. They're in conflict with each other so that you are not to do whatever you want." That's what Paul says in Galatians chapter 5. The day that you entered life in Jesus, you gave yourself the option to live in self-control. Today, trust Him to guide you in that self-control wherever you're at. Why don't you pray with me? Lord, I thank you so much that you give us the option of being in self-control. That all we need to do is look to your Spirit. It is a fruit of the Spirit. And so God, I pray today over every single one of us that in those moments where impatience comes on us and anger comes on us, that hot temper comes on us, God, help us to take a moment and say, "Okay, Lord, I need you right now." Give us that self-control. Show us those moments where we need your Spirit to guide us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks, everybody. Look forward to seeing you next time.